Ladies and gentlemen, the following eight-man tag team event is in for one fall. Introducing first the Four Horsemen at a combined weight of 1,091 pounds. Barry Windham, Arn Anderson, Vixen Vicious, and for the seventh time, the World Heavyweight Champion, Nature Boy, Greg Flynn. Woo! Here in Indianapolis, Larry Santos, David Isley, Tommy Angel, and Scott Summers. They all weigh in a combined weight of 989 pounds.
All right, fans, one of the teams that will be in the eight-man tag team in the War Games tomorrow night, live from Phoenix at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, and it's a battle to the finish, Paul, a surrender or a submission. But I tell you, they're so confident in this match, it looks like Arn Anderson doesn't even have his wrestling title.
No, AA is the world's television champion. That means, quite simply, he is the best wrestler on television today. The Horsemen are so confident going into the War Games tomorrow night that they said, hey, three against four, no problem.
Fans, only on pay-per-view, and you want to order now and you want to order early. But, Paul, can you really think of either one of these eight men submitting or surrendering?
No, quite honestly, I can't, because I've checked. And you know, Bob, I am wrestling's premier investigative reporter, and I found out that none of the eight men involved in the War Games tomorrow have ever submitted or surrendered.
Ric Flair, the World Heavyweight Champion, seven times the World Heavyweight Champion, gets a match underway with Tommy Angel as he backs Angel to the corner with that tremendous chop, and nobody chops like Ric Flair.
Nobody can throw a chop like Nature Boy Ric Flair. Beautiful back elbow by the World's Heavyweight Champion. Now, Bob, I'll ask you this. Which one of the four can make Flair submit or surrender tomorrow night?
I don't think anybody can. I don't think anybody can make either one of these eight men submit or surrender. Look at this tremendous machine, and that's all you can say about Sid Vicious. He's a fighting war machine.
Oh, he's ferocious, and he's headed to the War Games tomorrow night. I mean, 6'9", 330 some odd pounds. The meanest wrestler in the world today.
Well, and time after time, he said that all of his opponents are going to be carried out of the ring, and he's lived up to that in all of the recent matches that he's had. They've all been carried out of the ring, Paul. Look in the corner. Look at Barry Windham.
Now, you notice Windham, he comes right at you. Barry Windham is probably the most serious wrestler in world championship wrestling right now. Here he comes with a beautiful forearm smash.
Well, Windham again with the size and the power. As tall as he is, and with all that tremendous power, again with that right hand, takes him again right back to the ropes. Sets him right up for Vicious. Head slam right to the big foot with a foot right across the top rope.
I tell you what, this guy doesn't know if he's better up in the ring with Windham, Flair, or Vicious, but he's in the ring right now with the heavyweight champion of the world.
Well, I think Arn Anderson may have pegged it. These three right here may be able to do it all on their own, but they won't be able to do it against the four they've got tomorrow night in the War Game.
Well, now, how do you know that? I mean, that's the whole thing. If three men can dominate four men, what will happen when Arn Anderson's involved in the
match? Look at those chops again as Flair's got him into the corner, backed into the corner, but no three men can dominate Sting, Rick Steiner, Scott Steiner, and Flying Brian.
But it's not going to be three men, it's going to be four men, and it will be AA Arn Anderson, the enforcer of the Horsemen, in the War Games tomorrow night.
High backflip from the champ as he comes out of the corner,
oh,
makes
man.
The tag. Here comes Big Sid Vicious. A man that wants to put the hurt on you and hurt you bad. He wants all of the opponents carried out of the ring.
He's
no
not
way
a man.
Can you think of them submitting.
He's not a man. He's a monster. Invincible, invulnerable, indestructible. And now Barry's about to whip him in.
Can you imagine what the Steiners and those must be thinking in Phoenix if they're watching this?
I hope Sting and the Steiners are sitting back in Phoenix right now, really close to their monitor, checking out Missy in her all her fashions, watching this match right here.
Well, I tell you, Paul, too, after this match, you're going to be talking, I think, to the Horsemen in the Danger Zone.
Well, I don't think about it. I know about it. I will be talking to all four of the Horsemen who will be headed on the same plane that I will be to Wrestle War, the third annual Wrestle War, to the War Games tomorrow night, exclusively on pay-per-view.
All right, the tag now from Windham. He's going to hold him and set him up for the champ. Ric Flair, right to the attack to the midsection.
Oh.
There's that tremendous chop again as he has him back to the corner. Sets him for the right hand, measures him. Another powerful chop. Lefts and rights into the corner, right to the midsection. They're dominating this foursome.
Oh, they most certainly are. And remember, it's only three Horsemen in there. Oh, man, here comes Sid. Man, that Sid just wants to hurt people, doesn't he?
Oh, when you... You can't think of a man that is has it more altogether than a Sid Vicious. Vicious doesn't think, and I don't believe, there's a man in the world that can beat him.
No, not only that, but tomorrow night, these four will be inside a double enclosed cage. I mean, that's what I'm talking about, Bob. And here comes Double A, the enforcer of the Horsemen. Can you imagine when it's uncontrolled, when you can't stop it, when you don't have to worry about this qualification? It's going to be out and out 100% a war.
Back into the ring as Windham is waiting for him. He's going to set him up. Suplex, high in the air, powers him hard to the mat. Oh, he doesn't even go for a pin. He just backs away from him, Paul.
No, they most certainly are sending a message right now out to Phoenix, Arizona for Sting and both of the stupid Steiner brothers sitting there by their monitor. They want them to know right now that this means war.
Powerful move there by Barry Windham as he came off of the ropes. He had the power of the ropes behind that tremendous forearm blow. Makes a tag to beat Sid Vicious. Here's the man that really wants to finish them all off. Double clothesline.
I mean, every opponent that has stepped into the ring with this monster in the past few months has had his carcass carried out on a stretcher. This kid's going to be no different.
Well, Sid Vicious has really moved to the sadistic stage. He's a sadistic individual in the ring.
Oh, he's the most brutal of all the Horsemen ever. And here's the thing. I mean, he always has to work. Uh-oh. Looks like a power bomb! Wow!
Tremendous force to the power bomb from Big Sid Vicious. Just puts the hand across the chest. Well, Horsemen are the winners, but they're not finished yet as they still go at it in the ring. Vicious again lifts up Isley, power bombs him to the mat. He's gonna power bomb them all. One, two, three, and he's gonna roll them out onto the stretcher again. He wants all four of them to be carried out of the arena onto the stretcher. Vicious power bombs Tommy Angel. All four of them in power bomb by Big Sid Vicious as the Horsemen are ready for tomorrow and tomorrow night in Phoenix as they meet Steiners, Flying Brian, and Sting. All right. Fans right here, let's go back and look at some of the tremendous force. There is Windham with a suplex, rolls him over and covers him, but he's not going to pin him. He's just going to back away. Now look at the tremendous force behind the powerbomb. A big Sid Vicious as he gets him high to the air, drives him right down through the mat with a powerbomb as the Horsemen are our winners. And now standing by with a danger zone, here's Paulie Dangerously.
Tomorrow night, Sting, Flying Brian, and the Steiner brothers will enter the war games against all four Horsemen. And there's only one bottom line to this. It's submission or surrender. Nature Boy Ric Flair. It's bleed, sweat, and pay the price of a wrestling lifetime. Scars, scars, blood and guts, scars. We have all been in the war games. We have all survived. And you know what? We are all champions of the world. Tomorrow night, we find out if they can walk the aisle. Woo! If what I'm saying is correct, as you load up your sarsaparilla with one of those little umbrellas laying in the sun, we're loading our warhead with chemical weapons. You see, we've been there. Gentlemen, we're going to make the American Red Cross a Fortune 500 company. Don't make the one fatal mistake as you get your last workout in and lay in that sun, basking those bodies in these violent, trying times. Don't go off and leave your back door open.
Don't go off and leave your back door open. What does that mean?
You had a logic.